Thank you. cominciato a hoppo, ma punti da nulla.
The majority of the pre-pod race work is all new material that deals with introducing all the racers. We get to know a little bit more about the characters.
When we would look at the characters, sometimes just the very physiology of the character would kind of suggest what that character is going to do. For instance, there's one character, Arc Bumpy Roos. He's a huge alien, he's about 8 feet tall. And so we tried to find a character model somewhere between John Wayne and John Goodman. You know, just this big, gregarious, likable guy who'd be waving. There was Alain Mack, not a really super bright guy. He's kind of like a few fries or a Happy Meal. But maybe he was a mechanical genius who was really good at working on his pod.
A newcomer, moving up from the minor wind leagues. First time, big time.
He's kind of a goose-like character, so we kept him very bird-like. And he just kind of looked like a goose. When we were doing the shot of Odie Mandrell and the pit droids, animators, I guess, almost universally love Three Stooges, so we kind of had that in the back of our mind. It was definitely our nod to Stooges.
In the pre-punk race, we get to know a little bit more about Rod Sterrell.
We really approached him like he was a professional wrestler. He's a guy everybody likes to hate. But then on the other side of that, it cuts to his family who's there to cheer him on. And so you see the sweet little domestic scene of just like his wife and with the new baby.
Rod Sterrell's family was something that George had a lot of input in. It was fun because you also get to take a look at the characters, take a look at the history, even if that was a little history that that Rod Sterrell had.
When Jabba bites off the head of a frog and spits it into the gong, which starts the race, is a kind of a subtle event done tastefully for audiences of all ages.
George stops the tape and says, I always thought of having a shot of a POV of Jabba and seeing the frog as it's coming towards his mouth.
That was all George.
And we all laughed and we thought that he wasn't serious, but I guess he was very serious.
As is what when we're making the movie, we get a little over our, a little extreme in our sense of humor, and we had the shot of the actual frog about to be bitten. A lot of us thought it was funny, but it didn't make it into the movie. This did come from the fact that in Jedi that he did eat a frog. In that one, he ate the frog whole. I think we actually shot a little footage of the frog coming up toward his face, but it was a rubber frog and didn't really look too good at all, so we abandoned that idea.
I'm gonna take a break. Sorry, interrupted.
The pod race for me was the milestone of the movie. One of my favorite things is a bit with the salvage droids.
The salvage droids coming in is, again, one of those kind of digressions that is amusing, but it didn't really move the story forward.
I think one of my favorite moments in that is when Anakin comes sailing around the corner really fast and he collides with one. And there's just a beat, and all of a sudden, like, the head drops in your feet. That scene was all about doing the timing correctly.
That was really done by one of the animators once we turned it over them.
When we got the first animatic of Team Toe, there was one shot. Let me get a visual aid here. He was face-on in a pod, and essentially, he was riding in here in the animatic. But when we got the actual pod in front of us, the pod was more like this, and Team Toe was sitting in here. So, looking on the camera, you couldn't see him at all. And I said, we sort of have to solve this thing where, the pod's riding along and you have to be able to see Team Toe. So we said, why don't we just have him peek his head out like this? And he's looking over to the side, looking over to Anakin. And of course, that one thing led to another, and we said, why don't we have him get hit in the face with a bug? Kind of loses control of the pod a little bit and almost pushes Anakin into the cliff wall there.
There was a sequence I really liked. Originally in the race where Anakin lost the cable on one of his pods and became detached.
So we see the cockpit turning around, we see him stabilizing the cockpit, we see him pull a tool that we had never seen before. When we saw the original animatic, he didn't have a tool, but I think Ben, Bird, and George had worked on putting a tool there because that would be the only way that he could reach it.
ultimately, when we saw it where he just grabbed it, it didn't really seem to make much sense. So I added the magnetic device to sort of bring the loose cable in. Once we start to see the videomatics and the reality of the videomatics, I changed the way it works in order to make it more believable.
Thanks for watching.